the board for a moment. As I understand it, our reporter made inquiry before the board went into closed session, and I'm concerned to learn that apparently the board went in and included a member, a person who is not a member of the board and not a person who's employed by county government. Can you explain what the justification for his inclusion in the meeting is?
Ms. Trinicott?
I guess you can say he is employed by county government as a contracted service that the Board of Commissioners have with the Chamber to provide economic development work.
Well, a contractor and an employee are usually different. Is he an employee or not?
He is not a direct employee, but he is a contracted service and a service provider for Alamance County to provide economic development work.
Is it your view that he is subject, as other county employees would be, to the applicable statutes, both open meetings and public records?
I think he is a contracted service that, again, we have contracted services with many, many agencies.
But I'm not familiar that you've invited any others into a closed session with the board.
Because their work relevant for their purpose. He was.
Well, Mr. Chairman, Madam Chairman, rather, I'd just highlight that I find nothing in the statute that provides for anyone, frankly, other than the members of the board. We've never challenged having the chief administrative officer, the board's attorney, nor its clerk present in a closed meeting. But as best I can read the statute, the only members who are actually provided under the statute to go into closed session are the elected members of the board itself. I continue to be very concerned by this board and any other in which Mr. Williams apparently has some higher status than any other citizen in Alamance County and is invited to go into closed session with the board. Madam Chairman, you announced when you came out that there was no action taken.
Yes, sir.
Are you certain of that?
We did not take any action.
Did not authorize any preliminary or tentative agreement on a list of economic incentives?
I'm going to address that to Mr. Albright.
No action was taken.
All right. Madam Chairman, I'm just curious also.
May I ask a question? And I didn't know Tom Boney was going to be here tonight. And I didn't know, this is not orchestrated in the least, but I think everybody knows how I feel about a lot of this stuff now. And it's just, I'm going to take my stand and keep it. Was there a consensus given for action?
No action was taken.
Was there a consensus given?
No consensus was asked for.
Read the first one.
don't want to interrupt you, Commissioner.
I'm through.
Madam Chairman,
I'm through with the process. I can promise you that. As it's currently there, I'm through with it.
Okay. Madam Chairman, what is the amount of the request that was made in the closed meeting?
Mr. Albright.
All of that information is economic development information. And as you know, Mr. Boney, the board can ask anyone in a closed session that will further the purposes of the closed session.
My understanding of the statute is as to matters relating to the location or expansion of industries or other businesses in the area served by the public body, including agreement on a tentative list of economic development incentives. Already indicated that the board did not take action on a list of economic development incentives, but I'm curious as to what the request that was pending with the board is.
That's the subject of the closed session, sir.
My understanding of the statute is that it's the avoiding of identifying the business that is the subject of the closed session. It is the aspect that allows the session to be closed. You don't agree with that interpretation?
No, I think that the closed session is there for a reason. Anything that would thwart the purpose of the closed session, it's not required to be disclosed.
We would differ with that interpretation, Madam Chairman. I would just state for the record.
Okay.
I would also like to inquire as to whether members of the board have been asked to sign any sort of confidentiality agreement in connection with this project.
Yes, sir. We have not been asked to sign anything.
And have members of the county staff been asked to sign any such agreement?
No, sir.
Okay. Madam Chairman, I thank you. I do have a letter outlining my concerns about the closed session, which I'd like to give to each member. As I say, we do object. It's written in the future tense. Y'all obviously got into the closed session before I got back. Thank you, Madam Chairman.
Okay, thank you. Any commissioner comments?
Yeah, I'd like to say for the record, the type of process that's going on, the type of process that's going on gives, lends itself to confusion, mixed conversations being given, mixed figures being given, and I'm going to give you a point in case, and I'll be quiet. But I met back there years ago, maybe a couple years ago. X amount of dollars we'll talk about. Two commissioners went down to the chamber, double the figure, without the other commissioners knowing about it. Nobody was on this board at the time. I mean, none of you three. Double the figure without the other commissioners supposedly knowing about it, the three that didn't go. They take two, so it won't be a quorum. They went to the chamber. Then when the minutes came out, the minutes said it was total of the two figures that was back here. And I said, no, that's not what happened. I'm not going to vote for the minutes. So when... And then David Smith, our county manager, wanted to argue that, yes, that was the figure. And I said, no, that wasn't the figure. Doug Fincannon was no longer on our board. It was in the meeting. Doug Fincannon said, Tim's right. That figure was not, as the minute said. Chairman said, that figure sounds a little high. Dan Engel said he didn't remember. Bill Lashley wasn't there. So that left three commissioners, Larry Sharp, Dan Engel, and myself, that were back there. Larry said again, that figure doesn't sound right to me. Dan said, I don't remember. So I still maintained my position, and I wasn't going to sign off the minutes that said what the figure that they were coming up with, which was double what I was hearing back here. What the figure in the minutes was, what the figures were in the minutes was what was at the chamber and then what was back here combined. But they had to cover their, in my opinion, fanny somehow to justify that figure. So, again, with Dan saying he didn't remember, Larry saying that sounded high, somehow they both finally agreed to go against me, and we voted 2-1 to let the minutes stand at the gross figure that I claim and still claim it was a combination. That's the kind of stuff this yields. That's the kind of stuff that comes as a result of the process that's going on. We've got to have a better process, in my opinion, to recruit industry in this community. And I think we need to, I don't trust some of the people involved. I'm sorry, I just don't, point blank. And I'm fed up with it. And I'm not going to be a part of the process anymore. And I'm not anti-business, I'm not anti-recruitment, but we've got the best area, in my opinion, in the state for business. Location, water, cheap water, all the water you could want, reasonable wages that people want, non-union mentality, which I'm not going to say is good or bad, I'm just saying that's what exists. Yet the philosophy is we have to let the money roll off our lips as soon as we recruit a business. And I resent that as a citizen of this county. I think there's got to be a better way to do it. And Chairman Massey, with all due respect, when we met with Mac Williams down at Panera Bread, there was you and one commissioner brought in at a time until you got them all. Even that was skirting the issue. And the only reason I went down there was to look Mac Williams in the face and say, when you recruit industry, for gosh sakes, before the money rolls off your lips, let it roll off at the with the same speed that it would roll off if it was the chamber's monies or monies that the chamber had to go out and borrow and raise and so forth. That was my main purpose of going down there. So I've had my say, and I appreciate y'all's tolerance.
Madam Chairman, I'm very concerned to hear, Commissioner Sutton, I'm wondering what the time frame is for this meeting at Panera Bread that you just referenced.
Well, I didn't mean to get anybody in hot water here.
Well, I'm about to get them in hot water, but if you would just give the date that or the time frame.
I'll tell the truth.
I don't even know.
It was after the election.
Madam Chairman, that is an absolute violation of the open meetings law. It's called sequential meetings. And the courts of North Carolina have held that you may not do that kind of thing, in which you're polling individual members sort of one at a time when the chairman's participating in it in particular. And that case is, as I recall, in Jacksonville, Onslow County. I think it's the Board of Education. It's at least 10 years old, so it's a well-known case, and certainly this board, I would hope, is not engaging in that kind of violation.
We were not polled for anything.
Excuse me, the way the commissioner described it, at least, and one other commissioner were meeting one at a time. It's a rotating quorum, or a rotating non-quorum, I guess you would say.
We were not polled for anything. We were not asked, other than a confidentiality. We never signed anything. We were not polled.
Well, Madam Chairman, I think this whole area, as Commissioner Sutton has alluded to, is subject to such abuse, and the controversy surrounding incentives is a different issue that the commissioner has a position on, and I guess other commissioners do. Usually at election time, it's always stated as, I don't really favor incentives. Then when the time comes, we go behind closed doors with the chamber president in some special secret session and end up supporting incentives and spending taxpayer money, usually millions of dollars of taxpayer money.
We never talked about incentives. We talked about confidentiality if a company asks for it. That's what we talked about.
Well, Madam Chairman, I'm afraid that is not an allowable purpose for commissioners to get together outside of a meeting room. This meeting room is supposed to be where the transaction of public business concerning Alamance County government takes place, not in little powwows with coffee and donuts with the Chamber of Commerce president.
We never had coffee or donuts. I had nothing.
And bagels,
whatever it is you had at Panera Bread. I didn't have anything.
Those kinds of things are absolutely outside the realm of the open meeting statute and would be a clear violation of the law. And I'm very disappointed to hear that the commissioners have engaged in that at any time. Again, I think it's bad enough tonight. You go in with barely a quorum, as best I'm counting it. I assume Mr. Lashley's absent. Commissioner Sutton appeared to be in this part of the meeting room throughout the evening. And so you have three commissioners. And, Madam Chairman, with all politeness, I would just make the point that it's three Democratic commissioners, all of one party, who are meeting behind closed doors. That doesn't look good to the general public, regardless of their position on incentives, but just in terms of good open government, I think it really gives a bad, I'll say, odor to these proceedings. And again, I thank you.
Thank you. Any other announcements?
I want to ask about Time Warner. What can we do to get Time Warner to shape up a little bit more with their responsibility in our community? I mean, I've talked to Tim Burgess at length about several times about what their obligations are to us as a whatever they are. You know, they have pulled out of Alamance County, and I don't appreciate, what's his name at the COG, Dave Harris. He's supposed to be their liaison. He couldn't care less anymore. And I left a message for him, and he called me back. He would call me back, when it appeared that there was something. I had some cards to play with him, but then all of a sudden, they're out. They're not going to do what they've been doing. They don't show our meetings anymore. They don't show this. I don't think they do. They don't show the school board meetings anymore. I don't think they give a flip.
Somebody says something.
I think I saw last week.
I haven't seen one.
I don't know. I'm not sure. Somebody mentioned to me that they had seen it, but I don't know.
Yeah, they should have seen them somewhere.
I haven't seen one. If it's on there, I take it back.
Night.
I know I haven't seen one of ours.
Yeah, somebody told me that they saw me on there.
Now, I don't remember which was which. I think it was school board first, and then it was
all I see is they're sliding in cards with announcements. Yeah. With piped-in music from somewhere else, not from Alamance County. That's all I see.
Mr. Ward can answer the question.
Yes.
If I may, I apologize, I heard this. The latest update I had from Time Warner was a few weeks ago. The gentleman I'm dealing with is a man named Jason Dumas out of Charlotte. The process we have to get our meetings to them has changed. We now overnight a video to them. In fact, when I leave this room, I'm going to go upstairs, produce the video, put it in an envelope for FedEx, get it out tonight so that it'll be in Charlotte. Supposedly, it's showing Wednesday nights at 10 p.m. If it is not, I can get you his phone number and contact information, and you can certainly talk to him, and I can talk to him,
TV every day. I mean, I'll go home tonight and put it on Fox as soon as I walk the door, but I'll flip it through, and I swear I've seen nothing on Channel 5, mm-hmm. but sliding in of the cards for months.
I do know that he told me one of the things they've done in re-centralizing their equipment, this is what they've told me, they've pulled out of most of the local communities and centered all of their operations in Charlotte.
Yeah.
So all local governments who are having to do this are sending their stuff to Charlotte. It's getting retransmitted from Charlotte up to here. If there's an issue, there may have been an issue or lag time in between them getting it set up and getting it here. But I can certainly contact Mr. Dumas if you would like me to, and
I don't care. I'm just saying that it's getting broadcast. Hasn't done for this community what they promised they would do when they came in, and now that they're completely gone, I think we ought to find out if there's a way to hold something over their head. I can't get anybody to answer that. I mean, everybody seems to tell me that we
can't do anything anymore. We don't. The state now has a franchise, and we have lost that power locally.
Or what would we have to ever grant them any right-of-ways or anything for cable access? Something?
No, sir.
I find it hard to believe that we can't find something. But keep looking. And my last question is, I had a call before I came here tonight. I was on the interstate, and somebody called me about the school building that we purchased down here. Want to know what's going on with that, and that they'd seen a lot of work. Even I saw some landscaping going on out there. What's the status of all that?
There is a public garden. The public garden that was at HSC had to be relocated because of the roof work that was being done. I guess they didn't like roof particles in there, cucumbers. So we're allowing them in the short term to use the area over at the Graham School, but no construction from our end or anything.
No maintenance on the building.
That's all.
Okay.
I have one question, maybe for Tim. Where are you at in looking for the probation officers?
They are. We'll be coming to the board. Is it the first meeting in June or the second?
I think second meeting.
Second meeting in June. We'll be coming back at that point. They're looking at several different locations. The engineer's gone through and analyzed those. We found one location that we like, and the state happens to be the state property, and so we're getting ready to approach them about whether they would allow us to do what we'd like to do on that property. So that's kind of where we're at this point. So we should be back at the second meeting in June with the engineers coming back with their analysis of the different sites and coming back with a recommendation to the board.
Anything else? If not, we are adjourned.
We do.